What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Season 2 of Let's Play Career Mode on Expert. I stuck with Team Lotus. They should be a bit better now, of course, than last year, because there is an improvement across the seasons in your career mode. And yeah, here I'm messing about. I just discovered you can actually look around a bit more than just using the arrows or the pads. I am on the PC version, so if you use the numpad, you can actually like look around a bit more. So yeah, Season 2 of the career. I've installed a bunch of mods, you'll see this. The reason I put this off for so long, because I just couldn't bear driving his crap AI anymore. So I've installed an AI mod. These are the standings of last year. You can always go back to the last vid, of course, to see it, because the points are all gone. Improved AI, it's a team AI toolkit or something. I'm still going to be playing on Legend AI, everything the hardest as possible. No assists and shit. There you see my trophy. You saw my trophy there on the right. There's a little book here down there. If anyone notices, sees what book that is, I tried to zoom in on it to screenshot it and shit, but I couldn't see which book it was. It seems to be a book. And some pictures of some broads, probably some Codemasters people. So yeah, I'm going to do a bit longer stuff. Long race weekends, 40% races, mainly to avoid the pit stop bug and kind of get a better feeling of the races. 40%, it's not too long still. I'm not gonna do 100% races. I mean, I don't have an hour and a half to like edit and race first and then edit all of that stuff and shit. There's already a hassle editing and all that. So yeah, improved AI, Pirelli tires, 2011 car liveries, all that good jazz, all mudded up to the maximum. Before you ask, no, you cannot mod Xbox and PS3, so sucks to you. Yeah, it's only for the PC version, these mods. I'll put a link in the description if you guys want to try it out yourself. So yeah, Q1, Q2, Q3. First Bahrain video. I've been people asking me, where's Bahrain? Where's Bahrain? I need help on Bahrain. Well, there you go. Finally, a video on Bahrain. The missing track from the 2011 calendar because they start shooting their people in the face. Motherfuckers. So I'm getting through to Q1, Q2. Okay, fine. And this is my Q3 lap. And since I haven't done any hot laps on Bahrain, let's go on board for a hot lap on the Sakhir circuit. So flat out, of course, getting close to 300 kilometers an hour, break at the 110 meter mark, hit that apex, don't go too wide because you're going to have a good exit here. Be careful on that exit there on that curb, you might spin out if you're too heavy on the throttle. Short shift or either be a bit careful on your throttle input. Back up to full speed, break about the 80 meter mark, hit that apex, careful on the throttle again, you might spin out here. Flat out through here, but again, careful to spin out, there's a lot of bumps and stuff. You're flat out through this, you break just about when you see that sign on the left, cut that, give a bit of gas, drop down one gear to second, hit that apex, feather it through, and then bam, out of there. Down a third, and here another area where you can easily spin off, went a bit wide there, lost a bit of time. Get close to that apex, I miss it here a little bit again, so again, losing a couple tenths. Here you're flat out again, being careful not to spin out. This track is really, you gotta be careful with the throttle control. It's not that difficult as of a track, but just very bumpy, and I don't know, I find it hard to get good traction on this track. Very tricky corner coming up, braking while turning. Brake just about when you hit that first apex, bam, on the second apex. Don't want to go too wide or you lose a lot of time and have these silly curbs that hold you back. So we're going to the fast section here of the track, Herman Tilke style. Fast, long straight, Mickey Mouse, long straight, hairpin, long straight, Mickey Mouse. That's basically every Herman Tilke circuit in history. So flat out through here, that was a tricky section here, bam, down to fourth. Some people taking in fifth, I do take it in fifth, I think, in a better car. But I definitely feel an improvement in Lotus over last year, last season's car. So that worked out. Break at 100 meter mark, drop down to fourth or third. Don't get too trigger happy on the throttle because you might spin out again there. Yes, you've noticed, got to be careful on the throttle on this track. So that's the time of 156.155. In the other vids, I'm going to go back to see my my times I did in qualifying. But I can't now because I didn't do a vid on Bahrain. Just to see how much the car's improved. Of course, I've improved as well. Here you see the setup. I'm not going to discuss it. You'll just pause it and write it down if you want. My online setups are different to this. No, just the Lotus handles differently. So, but yeah, I forgot what I was talking about because I have brain farts like that from time to time. Oh yeah, I was going to compare times, see how the Lotus improved. I've improved as well a little bit, but probably not by a second. You know, so because I've been playing more. But yeah, could give a good indication. There's this table on that shows you the improvement of cars. Actually, there's five tiers for each five car tiers. So you have the lowest tiers, which is Virgin and Lotus and stuff. But since, you know, I classified well in the constructors, I'm going to move up a tier. So I'm in tier four. So that improves the handling and the engine. I probably could post up that table that someone made from the Codemasters forum. So taking a quick check here on the race strategy, lap 7. So yeah, I know this must be a surprise to you all. I said I was going to focus on the league races, but there's pretty much big gaps between some of the races. That doesn't mean I can't do the career races as well, right? I know a lot of you guys enjoy this, so I figured, hey, let's give it a whirl. And biggest thing holding me back was the crappy AI, and now with this AI mod, well, let's give it a whirl. This is the first time I've used it. I kind of did this as a test, see if I was going to enjoy it. And I found it was an enjoyable race, so I figured, hey, why not just make a vid and restart the series. Vettel on pole, good to this year's tradition. He's been dominating pole. Also like doing these career mode vids because it gives me more opportunity to talk a bit about real F1. Hope you guys like that as well, or hear me jabbering about real F1. But first, so let's get on board here for the start. I jink immediately to the right. So this AI mod also purportedly fixes fuel sim. It seems to be okay during the race. I don't have a huge disadvantage. Kubica pulls a fast one. Kubica pulls a fast one on the inside. There is a mod that exists that changes driver's name as well. Sad as we are all about it, Kubica is not in the 2011 season. And I doubt he will be even near the end. Because last I heard, he's basically walking, but not really, with like a little walker that you see old folks do. So right now, it's just 2 months after his accident, so I don't expect to see him in an F1 car this year, at least, sadly. If at all in the future, I mean, the dude almost had his hand cut off. We all hope he's gonna come back, but I'm in the pessimistic side, let's say. But here, of course, still getting it in the 2010 game. There is a mod that changes the names, so that puts Heidfeld in that car. And huh, I could have swore I changed the livery on that. Huh, gonna have to look, because I had a bunch of 2011 liveries, including the Renault, but this still looks yellow here. Maybe it has to do with the AI mod that changed some of my original liveries, so I'll have to check that out. You should get them. The Pirelli tires are working, as you can see, on the softs. There's no stripe on that. There's a new version, too, that has a stripe, but Pirelli is still gonna change their tires. How they show it, you know, I think there's gonna, what was it, actually where Pirelli is written, I think there's gonna be like a band of yellow or whatever color tires designed to. I think maybe in Turkey they have the definitive version, because this just wasn't viewable. You couldn't see it on TV screens if it was white or yellow. So yeah, so we're in P10, lost one spot to Kubica's Kubica. I keep saying it wrong, man. Don't hold against me, you Poles. I like Kubica, I just keep messing up when I'm saying his name. So I'm going to try to do my best. Here we have a Liuzzi having a peaky here on the inside. But he slots, no, that's not slotting back in, but I have the top speed advantage. Which is strange, Cosworth over Mercedes. I know Team Lotus now over Renault car. But man, Team Lotus this year, they're looking good. Yeah, sure, they won't be winning Grand Prix, but got to remember that last year they were nowhere. And now they're starting to peek their way into the midfield. I mean, they beat the Williams and Maldonado on pure merit in the last race. Maldonado on the supposedly superior three-stop strategy, and Kovalainen only on two stops in China, of course. And he got it. He finished like, what was it, good 15 seconds ahead of Maldonado, and only like 3 seconds adrift of Buemi. So yeah, Team Lotus is doing a great job. I'm thinking they're. They might even pick up some points this year in the right race, the right circumstances. So really, major props to them. Glad to see them. I really like Team Lotus. They have great engagement with their community. Lots of Twitter stuff. And then they invite people to go into the paddock and stuff. Follow at Spark Team Lotus or something like that. So they invite someone else at every race to like tweet for them. And you get like paddock access and garage access and stuff. It's really awesome. Yeah, so still in P10, just, you know, first two laps, figured I'd show them in its integrity. Of course, I'm going to cut, you know, I'm not going to show you, because what is it, 40% race, that's like 40 minutes racing or something, so that's a bit long to do it uninterrupted. But yeah, you can see already here the AI mod in effect. There's no big gaps opening up, the AI is not really streaking away. I am punching a bit above my weight, I feel here in the Lotus, just don't have the top line speed. basically the four Zinnias, that's doable to hold them off on a straight line, but then the top cars, McLarens, Ferraris, see later, and Kubica spins out. So yeah, another thing in this mod, AI are more aggressive, much more aggressive in the overtakes. So they do bump into you from time to time now. I think you can hear it now. Yep, boom, Liuzzi bumps into my ass. And the AI make more mistakes and shit, so it makes it feel more like a real race. And I don't get if modders can do this, unpaid amateurs. Look at this, this is weird. There's a yellow flag and it just turns green as I pass them. So they seem to be slowing down for a yellow flag as well. Yeah, I don't get if modders can do this, unpaid volunteers that don't have access to source code or anything, just mess with XML files and shit. And they can make the AI as good as this. You know, it's still not perfect, of course, but it's 5 million times better than what CM came up with in the vanilla version of the game. And why not put in the extra mile, the extra effort to really provide a superb offline experience for your customers? I mean, tell me, without this mod, I probably wouldn't have touched offline mode anymore. Maybe Grand Prix mode to practice for online races. Shows the game's still great because it's super enjoyable online. The hype for 11 is starting, of course. So yeah, we jumped a bit forward. There were people pitting, so we're now in P7, and well, not just pitting, but also that weird yellow flag issue with me bumping ahead of Hamilton, and I failed to remember who the one behind Hamilton was. Maybe Rosberg. So trying to keep Hamilton behind me, but he's clearly faster than me. Team orders in, of course, this year. This could be interesting. I wonder what what's going on with Ferrari. Their car isn't that competitive. And Massa's been pretty much on Alonso's level and even beat him pretty much fair and square last race. Still got beaten in quali. There's Hamilton popping on the inside. So you see they're much more aggressive now, the AI. Makes it much more fun to race against. So yeah, Massa beat Alonso, which was quite surprising to see, actually. I, for one, put my hand up. I said I did not see that coming. I thought Massa was totally finished. I mean, sure, the season's still long and he's going to have to keep it up. But he outright outperformed Alonso in China. Malaysia could have been close because without Massa's botched pit stop, he might have been right up there with Alonso until Alonso had the whole incident with Hamilton, which I discussed in my last league race, and it's so retarded I don't want to go into it anymore because Stewart's here. Look at how aggressive they are. Yeah, okay, this sucked a bit because he really did push me out. There's Kobayashi who passed me as well, and man, Kobayashi. Favorite driver in F1, hands down. I love Kobayashi. I really hope he gets a really competitive car under his ass at some point. I mean, Kobayashi is such an exciting driver. Oh man, his battle with Weber in Malaysia again, that was just such ballsy racing. And he did it all on a two-stop strategy yet again. Kobayashi, seriously awesome racing. So here it's lap 6. You can see my tires are all orange. So I called in to pit. Predicted pit stop lap was lap 7, but now lap 6 and I see everybody diving into pits. I'm like, oh no, I'm not restarting this. So I went a lap longer. This is my pit stop and it's much cleaner out there. Just a couple cars in the pits. There's some nice gaps. That's what you get when you do longer race distances, of course. It sucks though that the garage positions and numbers on your car don't change because I am the reigning world champion and I got number 19 on my car and Lotus finished 3rd in the constructors, but still in the back. I mean, CM can help that. That's most likely, well, almost surely, a licensing issue that they can't mess with garage positions and car numbers in the game. That's probably the very stringent F1 license, so you can't fault Codemasters for that. So we got out right in front of Massa, and he goes right through me. FIA for our international assistance, right? Just joking, but that was weird, man. It just goes right through me. Don't tell me it's lag, because it's not online. So Massa goes through me, but look at this. Oh, he goes wide and oh, Jesus, just jinked past him. Almost took him out and took myself out. Another thing in this AI toolkit is it has a frustration patch, it's called. I don't think I've mentioned this in the vid already. It kind of makes the penalties less ridiculous. Like if you have a little bump, or like I had here, the AI is more aggressive, so they're more likely to bump into you. And I would have probably gotten a penalty for causing a collision. So that would have made it impossible to race and, you know, have fun. So there's this frustration patch. So yeah, you can call it cheating or whatever, but I said last time, I'm just putting all the mods together I can find. I still have to put in the weather mod. I took it out. I used it for one league race, but Fraps didn't seem to like it a lot. It got a bit more laggy than it usually does, because usually it works fine. But with the weather mod, it was a bit laggy. But offline, I might just go ahead and bear with it. It wasn't very laggy, but just a bit more stuttery. So here's that was someone humping in the pits, and here I took a sip of water and didn't watch the road, so that's why I went off here, in case you're wondering what crack I was smoking there to go offline in the straight. Shit happens. Hey, you know, if Button manages to miss his own pit box, I am allowed to do that, right? That was one of the most hilarious moments in F1 I've ever seen. A car totally missing his pit box, that was insane. I've never seen that happen ever before, and I don't think we'll see that happen again. Button just wasn't on the money. I'm a big Button fan. I'm a McLaren fan in the beginning, I'll admit that. But, yeah, Button, I like him just a tad more than Hamilton. The Hamilton fan as well. But he just was not on the money in China. I mean, yeah, sure, he still finished fourth and qualified a great second ahead of Hamilton. But in the race, I mean, he just caught napping. He was, like, in the pits that really ruined his race. If he could have kept Vettel behind him, it's a possible 1-2 for McLaren, you know, in that pit stop. Because, of course, his fuck-up also meant... And another fuck-up, he went in a lap too late. Team called him in the lap before that, but he didn't come in. So he delayed Hamilton's pit stop, which jeopardized him. He made it work in the end, but very risky. Here we're trying to make a move on our good friend, buddy. And then when Hamilton passed him, he just kind of got caught napping. He could have easily covered off the inside, and Hamilton wouldn't have gotten through, but... He only realized it too late, and then, well, he had to steer out if he didn't want to take out his teammate, of course, because he was already on his inside. So, yeah, I'm surprised at Button's performance in China. But still, I've said it at the start of the season, he's my WDC prediction. So I'm going to stick with it, not going to change. I mean, he's still in pretty good shape in championship. But, yeah, what about Vettel? I mean, yeah, we're all talking about, yeah, Hamilton took the win and stuff. And, yeah, great stuff. It's nice. Even if you're a big Vettel fan, if you're a big Vettel fan, not. But for a neutral F1 fan, it's good not to see someone dominate the first three races and win. But don't forget, he came second in China, so he gets two wins and a second place. I mean, that's pretty damn good, you know. It's not because he came second that the race was bad, you know. Second, that's still a good 18 points in the bag. He's still 21 points ahead of number two in the championship. This is Hamilton now. But, yeah, so here you see a weird thing with this AI mod. I'm guessing it's the AI mod, probably is. Like, the top five are all, like, clumped up together. I don't know if it's going to be like that in every track. I know Bahrain's reported to be a really, really slow AI track. But, yeah, they got good pace on this. The final sector, they're maybe a tad too fast. Well, for me to follow anyway, they just brake so late and accelerate so early. It's just maybe not tweaked 100%. You can tweak individual corners with this AI mod, but I can't be bothered to really do that for every track. I mean, that's just going to take too much. I first need to do like a test race and then tweak the corners individually and stuff. I mean, it's a great tool, but I'm just can't be bothered. And here, actually, I missed my braking point. I go way too wide, but it almost develops into a pass on Button, who's to our right now. But he gets back in front. But yeah, that's put my hands up. Totally missed my braking point. And here again, so a bit sloppy. I could have gotten that position from Button, but got a bit sloppy. Was a bit surprised that my actual failure to hit my braking point actually was developing into a pass, which I then professionally messed up. Alonso's lean, of course. So, yeah, what I'm talking about, Red Bull, yeah, sure, they have the best car out there aerodynamically, but they're struggling with their curves a lot, and they're going to need it. I mean, look at how Weber got swamped in Malaysia. How Vettel probably would have been able to defend better if he had a better curve system when Hamilton came on. I don't think he used it the whole race again. Weber didn't have it available the whole race again. Poor fuck. Why are all the gremlins in Weber's car? I don't buy into the Red Bull favoritism story. Yeah, they do prefer Vettel, but I do think they give Weber equal treatment, at least in terms of at this stage of the championship. When it comes to like material and stuff, I mean, they're not gonna sabotage Weber's car because they prefer Vettel. Some of the Weber fanboys are a bit too stupid. I mean, he's not my favorite driver, but I kind of like Weber as well. But some of his fans are like, "What? What? You think they're knowingly sabotaging one of their cars so Vettel looks better?" I mean, this is a lot about money. The constructors championship is worth a lot of money. They're not just gonna sabotage one of their drivers to make another one look good. Maybe they might be a bit more harsh when it comes to wheel-to-wheel racing between them. But yeah, Turkey coming up in almost 2 weeks now. Jonesing again. Jonesing. I love these back-to-back races. Something to watch every weekend. Weed. But yeah, I'm thinking McLaren might be catching up to Red Bull. I mean, Red Bull's going to spend the best part of these 3 weeks desperately trying to work out their curse issues. Because that's pretty much the only thing bugging their car, aero-wise. They're great. And all credit to Adrian Newey for designing a great car again. But it's a pretty conventional build on the RB6. Nothing too, you know, strange. Yeah, they have the exhaust and stuff, but nothing too innovative on it. I mean, didn't need to either because the RB6 was already the best car. Now the RB7 is the best one. But look at McLaren. They have such an innovative car with the L-shaped side pods and what you know. And they had crap testing, so they didn't gather much useful data on their car. The only useful data I started getting on the car's configuration now is in Australia. So there's still a lot more to come from that car. A lot bigger improvement curve, in my opinion. It's not just because I'm a McLaren fan. In my opinion, I think McLaren, being so innovative, they have a lot more room for improvement yet to come. I mean, they need to get it right. That's one of their problems last year. They got the blown diffuser and they couldn't get it to work. And again, in Malaysia and China, you saw they brought upgrades, but it didn't work very well and stuff. They need to be on the ball, but in my opinion, McLaren has much more room for improvement than Red Bull was. If Red Bull doesn't work out their curse soon enough, because they're going to devote their resources to that and not finding improvements in other marginal areas. I mean, the big area for improvement on Red Bull is curse now. On McLaren, if they can work on their aero package, maybe develop a flexi wing like the Red Bull has, my prediction is McLaren is gonna either equal or even eclipse Red Bull sometime this season, just because they have such innovative design and it allows them so much more leeway to play around with things and develop new parts and shit. And in my opinion, it's a problem with Ferrari as well. They were just way too conventional again. The evolution of their car from last year. Red Bull can get away with it because their car was already clearly the best last year. And evolving that would be a good move. But Ferrari was, yeah, sometimes second best, sometimes third best, dependent on the races. Perhaps near the end of the season, Ferrari was ahead of McLaren again. Mid-season, it was McLaren ahead. Beginning of the season, Ferrari. So, you know, they were swapping spots, second and third best car. But Ferrari went very conventional on their F-150th Italia. Or what is it? F-150 degrees, whatever they call it now. Because Ford slapped them with a lawsuit. So that's what I think is going to hurt Ferrari. That there's just not that much room for improvement if you just develop, basically keep developing your old car and just adapt it to this year's rules instead of just throwing a blank sheet at it and starting afresh like McLaren did. It has its risk, like we saw in preseason. If they hadn't got that last upgrade, they would have been boned. But they got it. So yeah, we're in the final lap now, of course. You know, be honest, if you don't like me jabbering about F1 and want me to focus more on the racing itself in my game, just let me know. Otherwise, I'm just going to keep jabbering about F1. I could talk for hours about F1. I'm a true F1 maniac. I follow 5 million podcasts and sites and Twitter and whatever. But yeah, first race of the season, it was very enjoyable. There was just this weird part that the top is just so clumped up. I mean, looks like the tire wear is maybe not 100%, because at the beginning of a stint, I'm catching up or keeping pace, but near the end of my stints, when my tires are wearing out, the AI is pressuring me more. But here, yeah, you see the top 8 is within like 8 seconds, so which might be a consequence of the AI mod. It doesn't bother me too much, and here Massa bumps into my ass well, so they brake just a tad too late there, or I brake too early, but I don't think so. So that's Massa in a battle with Hülkenberg. Shame he's not in a race car. He's in the Force India for the practice sessions, but yeah, Williams got Maldonado instead. That's the end of the race. P6, fastest lap on the penultimate lap. Rob is happy, and the winner is, who was the winner actually? Alonso? Come on, move it up. I think Alonso won. Yeah, Alonso, Hamilton, Button, Weber, Vettel, me, Massa, Hülkenberg, Barrichello, and Kamui Kobayashi, Kubica, Senna, Rosberg, Buemi, Liuzzi, Alguersuari, Schumacher, Trulli, Degrassi, Petrov, Tango, De La Rosa, Glock, Sutil. So yeah, hey, good stuff, my Belgian brethren and the Virgin in the crappiest car alive. But yeah, you know, some points for Lotus on the board. It's always nice. Yeah, don't expect me to win the World Championship this year. I mean, with this AI mod, I'm not going to have these easy wins like I had last year. So, I'm not expecting to win the title. Hope you guys still enjoy the battles I'm going to have. But don't expect me to to win everything. And don't give me comments like, oh, I'm way better. I won a championship in Lotus. Well, you probably Steve, weren't using the, nice the mod. Well, I did a win it last finish. Year as well.
Very good.
Yeah, and Francois, yeah. Hey, I'm world champion. I'm not going to be excited about a point finish. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the return of Let's Play Career Mode on Expert Season 2 with Lotus. Next up is Melbourne, of course. Should get this out to you somewhere this week. Always subscribe if you haven't yet. So there's still going to be online league races following the F1 season. You can tweet me for questions, comments, updates on my videos coming. And if you just want to chat about F1 or see what I have to say about the races as they happen. Well, I'm usually not tweeting during the races because I'm so focused. But after the race, I kind of give my view. And, you know, you can feel free to, like, object or send me a question or give your opinion or whatever. So I hope you guys enjoy this one. Till next time, peace out.